Hey everyone, thanks for joining me and welcome back to my channel. We have seen this. This is the new Morphe James Charles palette. I bought it the day it came out at Ulta. I went over to Ulta first thing in the morning, bought it, and I'm so glad I did because by the time I left, this was sold out in that store. So what I'm gonna do today, you probably wanna know, it's not just gonna be just a plain look. I'm gonna do a full face using the James Charles Morphe palette. I'm a little nervous, I'm not gonna lie, but basically everything except for my foundation, which I already have done, and my mascara is going to be from this palette here. So yeah, this look is gonna be pretty wearable. So just so you know, it's not gonna be anything super crazy. I did play with this palette a little bit over the weekend and I am absolutely loving these green colors here. They're gorgeous. I did this really cool green look. The pinks are amazing. The thing that I'm not really happy with right now, but I will definitely use them, are these shimmer shades. I don't know. I know that there's like, there's a layer that I need to dig through so it will work properly, but I'm not finding them as easy to work with as the mattes. But I am finding that I am getting like zero fallout with this, which is kind of amazing. And I'm also finding that this palette is pretty much all in one palette. Like if I was gonna go somewhere, if I was gonna take a trip somewhere, this would be the only palette that I would grab. Because, I mean, it literally has everything in it. This palette has 39 shades. It retails for $39, so it's a dollar a shade, which is pretty awesome, if you ask me. A lot of these shades are pigments rather than eyeshadows, and I know James Charles went through it all on his video about it, and so it takes a little bit of a different technique to use them, but we're gonna do a pretty wearable kind of basic look today. I might do some blues. I'm definitely gonna stick to some neutrals overall, but I am gonna use this for the rest of my face with the exception of my mascara. I will be using regular mascara because I can't use this as mascara. So, but eyes, lips, cheeks, it's gonna come from here. So let's get started. I think what I need to do first is start off with a primer. I'm gonna use Primer Potion from Urban Decay. Now, I don't normally prime my eyes, but it is recommended and I have been playing around with it a little bit over the weekend. So this is what I'm doing. I'm going to start by giving a real basic overlay with Canvas right here. This is the very first color. Like it's like my skin color. I'm just gonna put it right over my eyes. Next, I'm going to go into the crease with Punch Me, which is this color right here, and just kind of give my crease a little bit of color. I have a mirror right here, so I'm just gonna use that. Now I'm gonna go in with a smaller brush and dig into Tea right here, which is a real nice cool tone brown. It's like literally the color of tea. It's actually really pretty brown, nice and neutral. Blend that out with a clean brush. Now I'm going to go into this one here, which is called Mary. And this color I find that I'm using quite a bit. It's really, it's a really pretty soft peachy pink. And I'm just going right over with it just to kind of warm it up just a little bit. I want to go into this one here, which is called Boutique, however you say it. Just go in to outer corner, up around to the inner corner. I think I'm gonna go into this purple here, which is Escape. I'm gonna go into Escape and just kind of add a little bit more punch here. Colors aren't quite getting muddy, which is nice. As you can see, I didn't have a plan for this today. So right next to it is called Single, and that's this purple here. And I'm gonna go inner corner there. And now let's do this center little bit here. Skinny little tiny brush. I'm gonna start off with this one, which is called Pinkity Drinkity, which sounds absolutely delicious right now. And I'm gonna go over the center with this. Dang it, there we go. And then I'm going to take some setting spray, my brush nice and wet, and go into Sister, which is this kind of peachy, pinky shimmer. And see how this works. I haven't actually used this one too much. Okay, so this shimmer is pretty good. Yeah, that one is actually really nice. The ones that I did really like was this one here, which is So Good. I feel like there's kind of like a layer on top that I need to get over. And then this one here, which is called Shook. It's a really pretty color, but I just can't get through that first layer for some reason. So maybe I will work with that more. I'm gonna put some of this in my corners. Now I'm gonna go under my eye again with this one, Mary. I just realized that if I wanna do my waterline, I have to do it with a powder, and I'm not excited about that. But we're going to make it work. I think I want to go in, this is Benny here, and this is another really pretty kind of dark plum. And I'm gonna do my outer corners in this. I just like darkness in my outer corners just because it kind of helps bring my eyes up a little bit. My eyes tend to kind of droop down a little, and bringing a dark color into that will kind of help it come up. And I know I'm not doing a winged liner today because I don't know if I can, but I am gonna go into this one here, Spooky, and do a soft liner. And I'm gonna use this for my lower lash line too. So Lord help me. So Spooky is going to the top. Let's get my brush wet again so I can go into that lower lash. And I don't normally use powder in my lower lash line, but we're gonna do it again with Spooky. All right, that wasn't so bad, was it? It was actually pretty easy. I'm gonna add a little bit more to the top here. Okay, with the exception of mascara, the eyes are done. I need to do my eyebrows badly. Let me put on some mascara. I'll be right back, and we will continue on with this look. Okay, so the eye look is done. Let's go with the eyebrows. And I don't normally like using powder on my eyebrows, so I'm a little concerned about that. I don't want them to look like caterpillars. Let's go back into T up here, and I've got this little tiny brush. This brush is like so skinny and angled. I absolutely love it. It is from Sephora, and it's in one of their holiday collections, but I believe you can probably get something like this from Sephora just as this, but it is like so sharp. It's so nice. So I'm gonna use this. and start filling in my eyebrows with tea. See how this works. If you have lighter brows, I'm sure that the other brown shade in here, Punch Me, would probably be pretty good for it. It's very kind of blonde and it's still kind of neutral. It actually is a little bit on the yellow side, but I think it could work for brows. Seeing as my bangs covered anyways, I'm not gonna care. So next we have the cheeks, and I think using these two shades here, Mary and Literally, just kind of swooshing them together with a brush will work. I don't think I'm gonna do contour today. I don't do a whole lot of contour anyways, so I'm okay with not doing that. So let's swish these together. Let's add a little bit of Pinkity Drinkity in there too. Is Pinkity Drinkity? No, Sister. Got a little bit of Sister here too. So I'm gonna go across all three of these. Oh, see, that works. That works really well, actually. Look at that. That's actually really super, super pretty. Okay, so last thing we have is the lips. So I'm gonna grab a little lip brush and I'm gonna see how this one works. This is Boutique again, and just kind of do it dry, but then I have an idea if this isn't quite work out the way I want it to. Actually working okay. Let's try my finger. So my idea was gonna take, I wanted to take some clear gloss and mix it in. I'm gonna go back into Boutique, pick up some of that with my brush. So I'm mixing it in here. Then I wanna go into Love That, this pink here, just to kind of give it a little bit more of an oomph, and mix that in as well. See what that does. I might need a little bit more gloss though. Mixing that in and kind of making a gloss out of that. That's so much better. I'm gonna use my finger. The only problem is it feels kind of thick and kind of sticky, but oh, that's good. Okay, so what I ended up doing was I used a clear gloss. I used this one here, which is Love That, and this one here, which is Boutique, and I mixed it all together, and then I kind of went over it with my finger. Added a little bit more of Love That just on top, just to kind of give it a little bit more of a berry look. So I think because I did that, I'm gonna add a little bit more Love That to my eyes, because I don't think I used this shade. And just to kind of tie it all together, I'm just gonna put it on the outside and on the inside. Okay, and now the last thing is a little bit of highlight. And the last thing is a little bit of highlight. And so what I'm going to do with that is use Face. And this is really easy part. Just grab some highlight on a fan brush. I don't like this brush. I'm gonna use my tapered brush for this. I love using this for highlight. That's better. And I'm gonna add a little bit of Face just below my brows. Okay, so you know what I said about the shimmers, not liking them too much? It really depends on what shimmer I use, because I'm seeing some that I'm actually really enjoying. So I take that back. Oh, my hair is so bad right now. I am in desperate need of a haircut and a dye job. So there you have it, full face of James Charles Morphe palette. I'm actually pretty happy with this because this is gonna make my travel a lot easier if I'm able to just go to one palette for almost everything. I'm really, really pleased with this. So you can find this at Ulta and Ulta.com. I would call the store to make sure it's still in stock, and check the MorpheBrushes.com site to see if they have it in stock again. Because I know it sold out pretty quickly. But yeah, what do you think? If you like these types of videos, be sure to hit that like button. Be sure to subscribe and hit those notifications so that you know every single time I upload. And thanks so much for joining me. We will see you again next time.